What's up, guys? We are now back in Arizona. I guess this would be about day 7, I guess, working on it. Has not been consecutive days of actually working on it, so but I believe this would be the 7th day of the project. Anyways, we're back at my home in Phoenix, Arizona. Still here with the 6-speed swap Dodge Charger. And the only thing we are currently waiting on is the computers to come back, and hopefully they'll be back by this weekend. It is now Thursday. So that is the goal, to be able to fire this thing in the next couple days. Make sure it runs, drives forward, backward, all that stuff. As far as today goes, we are going to be making a panel to fit in the center console area here, to be able to hold the actual shifter bezel for the Challenger. Obviously, the Challenger one right here won't work. I've thought about maybe cutting that one up and trying to make it work, but the placement of it and all that stuff, it's just not gonna work. So thought about cutting up the factory Charger one to go in here and then placing it so this bezel will go on there, but it's, again, it's one of those things that it would require quite a bit of modification and wouldn't really look how I want it to look in the end. So I think is what I've come up with is the idea. And as you can see here, I have my air fuel gauge mounted up here on just like a little piece of aluminum, mainly for data logging, and it's a good place to be able to see it when the car's running. I can kind of look down. I didn't really want it up high or obstructing my view or anything like that. So the thing is, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this out. We are going to take out the factory like little coin tray back in here with the cigarette lighter. There's no need for the cigarette lighter to be there anymore. So we're gonna pull all that out, I think. And then I have some real thin gauge aluminum. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make a panel to come in here and kind of cover up this, and it will blend up into the dash, and then we will re-put this gauge in that panel. It'll kind of be like a one piece. I think we're gonna pull this out, like I said, and then it'll have a little lip underneath the HVAC controls down there. Sorry, I know it's super hard to see. Under here, and the hardest part will be to figure out exactly how we are going to make it actually stay, because the factory clips are here, here on each side and up here, and as well as it kind of slid into the front. So that'll be a little bit of a process, but as for now, we are going to, I'm going to take the shifter off, and I have some cardboard. I'm going to pull this stuff off. Some cardboard. We're going to see if we can figure out a good way to make this panel sit kind of flush and look kind of factory. It is just raw aluminum. I have a few smaller pieces. Sorry, my garage is currently a mess. A few smaller pieces right here, like this one, or I have a big like two-foot by four-foot sheet, which hopefully I won't have to use that. But let's go ahead and get the shifter out, and then we're gonna use some cardboard, see if we can mock it up and go from there. Alright, guys, so kind of scrapped the idea of making a whole new piece out of aluminum. Now, I know you're looking at this like this thing is fucking ugly. I understand. This is the OEM auto shifter that I cut everything out. Now, I would have loved to have used said bezel, but Let me push this in here real quick. As you can see, it's got a big gap on this side. So, I cut it out so the actual clips will sit down inside there, mostly all the way around. This side's not as pretty, but I have a solution to fix the top of this. Now we're back to our aluminum. So now I traced out the top part of this thing here, and is what I am going to do is cut this part out here. We're gonna lay it on top, and then I'll vinyl wrap it on top of that. That'll kind of give it a nice black look there. The chrome trim ring will kind of stand out around it. This part will be fairly easy to cut out. I have to cut out this center piece here, which will then fit all these little clips in it. But I have to be very careful when I do it on here, because that's going to be the final showing piece. I'm essentially just using this here mainly as a mounting point for these clips here, because all these clip back into the factory location in there. So I know it looks really ugly, but it's going to work as far as holding down a piece to be able to hold the actual shifter bezel on there. I know I was doing pretty good with the whole time lapse on doing some of the cardboard stuff, and nothing I did I really loved. So now we're gonna revert back to this. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut out the aluminum now and get this piece cut out, kind of laid on top, make sure everything looks good. We're gonna final fit the edges first, then we'll go in and cut out the center of it, and that will allow us to be able to actually put the shifter down. All right, guys, back in the car. The process was not pretty on the making of what we did here. And I'm not even necessarily done with it yet. But as you can see, it's got a little fitment issues. But I think is what I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap this piece in vinyl. I have some black vinyl, or I have some brushed metallic vinyl that I use on the outside of the cart. And I might wrap this aluminum here in vinyl, and then I think I'm going to use a 3M double-sided tape to, let me see, there we go. So this is not the part that's so pretty, but like I said, I mainly, the only reason why I cut this up and use this was for the actual mounting tab. So you can see it clicks in, so we can mount that in there like so. Then we can put our shifter in, and we'll have to put the shifter bolts in before we mount that down, which we can still get to there. Looks like it's got free range of motion. Got plenty to go over for reverse, since it's got an electric reverse lockout. Won't let you go in reverse unless the car's on or something like that. So I'm gonna make a few final fitment things here. I'm really mad at myself because I nicked it right here and right here, but whatever, race car. So I'll make a few small adjustments along here just to get this to kind of set down past this molding here, and it'll sit a little flusher on the plastic underneath. And then we're gonna put some vinyl on it, stick this piece back on there, and I think we're just gonna send it. And there you guys have it. As you can see, that front piece isn't in. We have a little bit of wiring to do for a push button start, so I don't want to secure all this stuff down yet until that's done. But you can see I got the brush black vinyl on it. We're gonna use 3M tape to stick it down to this surface, and that should securely hold the top panel to the bottom panel. And but there it is. It looks about as OEM as you can get, while using some aftermarket parts and a little bit of time and a little bit of patience. So that's probably gonna wrap it up for right now. Computer should be here, and next thing we'll be doing is hooking the body control module back up, PCM back up. I think I have a pinout to do in the PCM. Cut a wire in the RF hub and ground that out and hook up a starter switch. So we're gonna get that taken care of shortly. What's up, guys? So we are back and we now have a surprise that now all of the computers and key are back. Sorry, this RF hub's open right now, and yeah, we're gonna do a little bit of modification with the pinning, but we got all the computers back from AJ at Hemi Tuner Performance. Big shout out to him. He sent us some wiring diagrams. We're gonna hook up a few wires. I de-pinned my old engine harness so I get a couple pins with some wires coming out of it. We need to, underneath here, so this clutch wire here, the clutch interlock, it picks up the interlock, up switch, and a ground. So there's three wires in here. Let's see if you guys can see this here. Three wires in here. We need to pin those. We gotta run one wire up to the PCM. We need to replace the RF hub up in the deck lid up there, where that little pink red thing is. We have to run a wire off the clutch back there, and then run one from the RF hub back up to the PCM. So I was just taking some pins out ahead of time, and we need to repin them into the C connector in here for a startup switch. We were originally gonna wire it up on a secondary startup switch, have a fire on crank. We decided to not go that route. We wanted it to be more OEM style. So that's what we're gonna do. So you can see the center console shift panels in here. So now that we figured out all the starting thing, I need to put the front coin tray back in, which I have up here, and then hook back up my air fuel gauge, do all that stuff. You can put all that stuff back in. Probably be some of the last things I do, because it doesn't need to have that in there to test fire it. We want to make sure that it's actually going to fire, work, do what it's supposed to do. So I'm not as worried about hooking everything up. The dash panel has to go, or the under dash panel under here has got to go back in, just because it's got a bunch of stuff that needs to get hooked up, lights, and then you got this little, I think this is the RF hub signal wire. So we got to hook all that stuff back up, and then we can test fire it. I don't know if it's going to get test fired today. I know after talking to AJ, it has a stock 6.4 tune calibration in it, which could make things get a little bit weirder. With startup, we're probably going to fire it, make sure it runs, and shut it right back off again. We're not going to be able to drive it, but we want to make sure it's going to fire. I'm sorry, I live right by an Air Force base. So we're going to get started on that. Like I said, I already got the pins out of the old ECU plug, so we have some wiring there. I'm going to tag these in. We're going to run some wire off the clutch pedal. We are going to run them back to the RF hub, install the new RF hub, and then hopefully test fire the car. All right, so is what we ended up doing was taking off this little gray cover here. You stick a flathead kind of on either side, work its way up. Just be careful not to pry on the outside edge too much. I found the pin connectors. Now it's really hard to see. I can't really show you on the video, but the unused pin connectors that, whether because this gray plug right here, this C connector, is actually attached to the car itself. So it's attached to the dash, I guess. It's all the stuff that kind of controls other things like radiator fans and AC clutch and all this other stuff, but it gets its signals from the PCM and whatnot. So anyways, for the connectors that don't have any plugs in, you kind of see it right there. They have a little block off, like a little plastic block off in them. And they're actually still attached. So as what I use is, I use this little dental pick here. And if you look at it, it's got like a cross hatch in it. So I knocked all four corners and it kind of poked it through. And there's a rubber watertight connector that goes around it so water can't seep past it. And that's what I did. Was just use some regular old solder wire here, and I pushed it through from the wire side and pushed the actual plastic connector out through where the connector would be. So I put it in through the female side and kind of pushed it out through the male side, if that makes sense, on the connector. So we're able to work those out. As you can see, I have the two wires here. The brown one is going to be for the up switch signal sensor, and then this blue one here is going to be for the actual clutch interlock. Now I have this red wire running right here, kind of ran it through the firewall. I think this is what I'm going to do is I'm going to utilize all the actual NAG1 shifter cable hole, and that's how we're going to run the wires through. Now there's only one wire coming off the actual clutch pedal assembly that goes directly to the PCM. So I use the short piece of red wire. I'm going to be able to hook that up. There's another one that has to go from the clutch switch back to the RF hub in the trunk, as we discussed earlier. So I'm going to start working on that. I'm going to get some wire laid out so I can get all the lengths right and do all that stuff. And then all right, so we got the RF hub wired up. I ended up soldering the connections on the bottom of the board. So I got two attachments up there now. I already cut the length of wire we need. I'm gonna run the wire and follow the factory wiring all the way down. I am in the middle of looming it up right now with the expanded wire loom like we talked about before. So we're gonna go ahead and finish getting the wire loom loomed up, cut it to length, plug it in the RF hub, run the wiring forward to the clutch, plug it into the clutch switch, and run the two wires up to the PCM, and then should be able to start putting a few things back together, maybe be able to test fire it today, we shall see, depending on how far we get on the wiring, and getting some of the interior stuff back together. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so now you can see we got the connections made. And get some better light here. The connections made right there. I stuck some heat shrink. Let's see if I can turn this heat shrink over the lines. I haven't heat shrunk it yet, but what I'm doing is insulating those lines so they don't cross and hit each other. But as you can see, we have the wire loom all ran, and we're gonna zip tie it up nicely or use some gaffer's tape and tape it up with the rest of the harness. Absolutely love this wire loom, and I didn't show you guys quite right there, but the only issue with it is that it tends to fray like this. So what I always do is stick like an inch or inch and a half piece of heat shrink on the end of it after I run the wires through it and do what I need to do, and then heat shrink it down. It kind of keeps all this together and keeps them nice and tight to the wires, makes it look a lot cleaner. So now that we got those wires ran, we are going to hook up a connector on this end. This is the clutch interlock side. And then we're gonna run this brown wire up to the pin 87 in the engine bay. And then we're gonna run the red wire in the engine bay back, and that is the clutch up switch. So we're gonna get working on that. All right, so we got some stuff buttoned up underneath the dash. I forgot that I had to run a ground wire for the clutch switch, which is now mounted right under here. I don't know if you can see that, but now mounted right there. I actually took the kick panel airbag out on the knee can of the the knee panel kick pad or airbag, I guess. I took that out as this is pretty much just a race car at this point, so weighs a few pounds. We got the Bluetooth module kind of mounted up in here. We got the TCM wires up out of the way, and I got some of this stuff plugged in, but I wanted to show you guys something for anybody working on a newer Charger or Challenger. Chrysler 300. It's right there. You see that white block? That is a for your key, the RF hub antenna. So I did this before I took it out. I took a picture because there's a lot of wires that are the same color within this thing. If they do not go back in the right way, from my understanding, the car will not start. So to alleviate that headache, I have opted to go ahead and I took a picture of it before we took it apart, and now I should be able to follow the picture and put it back together. All right, so now the body control module is all plugged back in. A little note that if you ever take your BCM out, see those little stickers? There's like a blue one. There's a couple black ones up in there. And then there's some that don't have stickers. That indicates the plug color. Makes it a lot easier if you're ever in a rush like I was when I was pulling them out. Makes it a little bit easier when you're putting them back together. The PCM is plugged in. I had to order a new PCM bracket because apparently I lost mine. I'm thinking that it's up at the shop still, but we just ordered another one. It was only $11. So I may or may not do it for today. I have not yet decided. I'm going to go inside and do some research as far as the C100 plug. Remember, there's six wires we need to hook up in there. Make sure they're in the correct pinout. I think a couple of them are, but a couple of them need to be moved around. So we just need to, essentially, we just need to move them around, but I gotta figure out what the wiring schematic is for both the automatic and the manual. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Maybe I can knock that out before tonight. I can move some pins around and we can test fire the car tonight. AJ really wants to test fire the car, make sure it's gonna actually do a thing. RF hub's all wired, clutch is all wired, PCM, body control module. So hypothetically, if everything's wired right, programmed right, all that stuff, it should be able to fire. I just want it to be able to fire and physically move forward, move backward. We're gonna shut it back off. And we got to load a custom tune-up in it for, obviously, the modifications that are done. So, if we don't come back today, we'll be back tomorrow at it. But for now, I'm going to go do some research. I know it's been kind of a boring, kind of odd day. But thank you very much for sticking around. And hopefully we'll see you guys soon.